Hello everybody, I am Dr. Akhil Dadi, joint replacement surgeon and CMD of Srikara group of hospitals. Today we would like to discuss about knee pain and newer technologies, newer methods of doing total knee replacement. After this we would also talk about lesser done but more important total hip replacement. It is very clear that knee pains, suppose if we see in our group of hospitals, we see 4,000 patients in the outpatient every month. We only do replacement to 150 or at the most 200 people. So the percentage of people who suffer from knee pain but who require knee replacement as an option is only about 3 or maximum 5% in people who suffer from considerable knee pain. The rest of the 97% are managed with medicines, exercises, change in lifestyle, and most of them continue like that. It is only after in this 97% again only another 3-4% over a few years would require knee replacement. Also, what is more important is to know who really requires a knee replacement. A knee replacement surgery is needed by those who have pain from many months or years. Most of the people at least have pain for more than a year. So that is point number one. Second thing is the pain does not allow you to walk with comfort beyond half a kilometer. Generally, it's about 200, 300 square yards or half a kilometer. For people who walk about a kilometer, we generally do not recommend a knee replacement surgery. Third thing is climbing stairs up and down is very difficult. Getting up from a chair is difficult. So these are all things which are required in daily life. They are all difficult because of the knee pain and not because of anything else. It has to be the knee pain. Also, the increasing deformity due to wearing out of the knee is another factor which is considered along with the pain. Added to this, the patient has tried all methods of medication, of exercises, of injections given, of some Ayurvedic, homeopathic. So the whole gamut or a few of them options have been tried by the patient, but everything has failed or nothing is working. Nothing is relieving the pain to an extent where they can walk half a kilometer. So most of the people with this kind of a severe knee pain restrict themselves to the household, going along with the family for a function, for a movie, trying to get into a car, an auto, a bus is just impossible. So that life beyond the house and life inside the house is restricted due to knee pain. Sixth, last point is with all this disability and issues, the X-ray also shows complete wear out of the knee. These are the 6 points which you have to consider. All these 6 points are considered, and if all of the patient has all of these 6 only, we have to do a total knee replacement. Now, having said this, once the patient gets convinced, the doctor also gets convinced that you require a knee replacement, we all consider evaluation of a patient is very important apart from their consent. In the evaluation, the patient undergoes tests for the heart, and nowadays heart tests are going beyond ECG and echo, include dobutamine stress echo, and we are very happy and surprised that a lot of patients are even accepting angiogram as a test to check their heart status before the surgery, so that issues post surgery or during the surgery are almost brought to a nil, a zero status with these precautions taken by us preoperatively in investigating the patient. Apart from this, the doctor explains to the patient, and the patient who wants to undergo knee replacement understands that recovery differs from person to person. Somebody gets injured, it's like injury. So somebody gets injured, your recovery, I might recover in 15 days, you might recover in 1 month. Everybody walks in 2-3 days when they are in the hospital, at least to the bathroom and back. But the later part of the recovery varies from 10 days to 2 months. Some people even take a little more long, because the healing inside their body, the complete healing to a knee replacement, might differ from person to person. Most of the people start doing, the ladies especially, start doing their household work within 1 month of surgery, and within 2 months most of the people are ready to walk outside, drive their car, climb as many stairs as possible. We know so many patients who do walking even up to 6-7 kilometers post surgery, people who climb stairs to Tirupati and up some other place where they have gone for worship. So people have done a lot of their routine normal activities, extra normal activities also after knee replacement. Second thing is where the patient has to understand that there is a risk of infection. So every orthopedic surgeon who is doing joint replacement as well as the patient who is undergoing this surgery should understand that just like any surgery has some kind of a risk, the biggest risk of a knee replacement is an infection. It differs from 1%, 1 in 100 to 1 in 200, 1 in 300. And it comes when your immunity also goes down, even 1 or 2 years after surgery also you might get it. So most of the people get dejected when they listen to this, but they have to accept this fact. They should be ready to face this whenever it comes. It is very, very rare. We say like it is an accident on the road. To whom it happens, when it happens, we do not know, but we are prepared. And now with this, the acceptance has gone up, and people, whenever they have a complication of infection, their acceptance of revision surgeries, doing surgeries back and cleaning the infection, putting a new implant again, which takes about a 3-4 month time again, this acceptance has gone up very high, thankfully, because the understanding amidst patients has gone up. Having said this, having prepared the person for the knee replacement, whether to go for one after the other or to go for both at the same time is what the patient, the doctor, and the investigations and the circumstances decide. So this is another story. There now the number of bilaterals which is being done on the same day has come down a little bit. So most of us are doing one knee and doing one after the other rather than doing on the same day. The percentage of doing bilaterals both on the same day was very high previously. It has come down by about 20-30%. This ratio has come down. So coming to the surgery is like changing the tire of your car. So this is the knee. It is covered, it is protected by cartilage. Again, it is protected by cartilage, lower it down, and it is protected by these two washers which we call the menisci. Now in arthritis, there is a loss of this cartilage, the menisci is worn out. So the bone and bone rub with each other and cause pain. Now in a total knee replacement, this worn out cartilage is replaced by the femur side. This femur is placed here, and this lower end tibia and meniscus are replaced by a metallic plate and a washer. The patella is not replaced by us. Some surgeons prefer to resurface it, but we do not do anything much to the patella. So coming to the implants, the material with which they are made up of. So from the beginning, it has been made up of cobalt chrome. Even today, the maximum used metal is this. Now, the cobalt chrome still remains the mainstay, and we say that it lasts for about 20 years, but we have patients who have now lasted beyond 20 years also. And the chances of allergy or infection are probably 1 in 500 or 1 in 400. The newer materials are like titanium nitrate, which is called sweetly called gold, bionic gold. Here, you know, there are multiple layers in this which reduces the release of ions from this. So the chances of allergy and probably infection are a little less than cobalt chrome. So this is another newer material. And another material which we have been doing from the past 6 years very extensively, and we are known for doing oxynium. Now oxynium is a metal called zirconium, the surface of which is coated, is oxidized. So oxidized coating on zirconium is oxynium. Now this has been tested in the labs in the US to last for 30 years, but patients who have lasted with this for 30 years are probably not there in the world. Another thing is the company which has the patent, Smith & Nephew, says that the risk of allergy is a little lower with this. So probably the risk of allergy and infection is a little lower than the cobalt chrome. But cost also plays a factor. So we discuss all these issues with the patients, and we ask them to select based on their costing and on their budget, because there is no great difference amidst these three needs. Yeah, if you have the money, oxynium or bionic gold are a tad better than the cobalt chrome implants. Now, what are the methods of doing a total knee replacement? It can be done in the conventional method, and most of the earth it is done that way. Then we also take help to increase accuracy of the surgery, because a lot of angles, cutting of the bone and cutting, how many millimeters to cut, what angle to place the implants in, with all these issues in mind, newer technology was first created to make accuracy a mainstay. And that is when computer navigation, the use of a computer to tell us where we are going wrong and correct the angles, give precision, give accuracy, computer navigation came in. But in computer navigation, the computer was passive. The surgeon had to decide what are the corrections to be made. So the next step over that was robotics. We are one of the few centers in the world and in the country which has robotics. In the robotics, a robotic arm is there in my hand. And this robotic arm not only sees that the accuracy and precision is maintained, it helps in doing the surgery accurately. And if I am doing a mistake in cutting too much bone or trying to touch unnecessary areas, the robotic stops me. It stops the surgery. So I, along with the robotic arm, it is a surgeon with the robotic arm, ensure that there is no damage done and the surgery is accurate and precise. So that is the advantage of robotics. Now, robotics is more useful in uni, which are the half knees. It is also useful in knee replacements, but we do it only, not for everybody, we do it for only a selected few patients. These patients are somebody who wants to get it done, as well as who has where we want to preserve more bone and be more accurate, like in the younger. We cannot do it for the whole lot of people. Having said this, robotics is a far better and advanced technology than the computer navigation. And definitely, if the surgeon has the time, it gives an edge over the conventional way of doing a knee replacement. So with these few things, we also talk about the recovery. Patients stay for a single knee in 2-3 days in the hospital. Patients who undergo bilateral about 4 or 5 days. We want them to go to the bathroom and come back. That means become almost independent and then start on their work as soon as possible. There is only one physiotherapy exercise after the surgery. And we wish that each of the patients who undergo this all over the world understand that there is only a stretching of the knee and folding, the so-called active quadriceps. There is only one kind of exercise which you need to concentrate, do and understand in total knee replacement. There's nothing else to be done. So don't do about 10-20 of those exercises, and don't allow the physiotherapist to forcefully push your leg, which is the only reason for severe post-operative pain after going home. So please do not allow anybody to add insult to injury. You have undergone a surgery, and if the physiotherapist is forcefully folding it, it is just adding insult to injury. They should not be doing this. So that is about total knee replacement. And please be very frank with your doctor, open, as well as understand the pros and cons of the surgery. Otherwise, it is one of the most successful surgeries in the history of surgeries, because 99-98% is very high success rate as far as any surgery is concerned. Thank you.